This is Napster Live. We are joined by Acceptance today here in our offices.
Seattle's own.
Seattle's own. So, how about it?
Thank you. All right. Jason and Christian out with you guys today with Acceptance, and we're going to play three songs off of our record Colliding by Design, which is coming out in February 24th, and one song off of our record Phantoms that we put out in 2005. So forgive us if we don't know any of our own songs because they're fairly new, but we'll have a good time playing them. So we're going to do, what do you want to do first?
We're going to do Diagram of a Simple Man.
Okay. All right.
I think it goes something like this.
Yeah. Put on my name tag, stare in the mirror, give me some answers, make it clearer now, and then I'm in my head. As the sun is getting older, while the year is counting over, am I more than this? We get caught up between the sea and the sky. Give me that look in your eye. We live in black and white. We dream in color. Stranger near my station, he said you're alright, take a vacation, the things to see before I'm dead. As the air is getting colder, while the years are turning over, where will I exist? We get caught up between the sea and the sky. Give me that look in your eye. We live in black and white. We dream in color. Oh,
Cheers.
Hey, cheers.
Way to go.
Hey, Seattle is right behind us, literally. They can see this, right? Everybody can see this? This is beautiful. This is why I didn't leave, even though when Christian left, he wanted me to. He went to Florida. I mean, it's great.
Come on, man.
Come on. Florida's fine, man. It's good. He's like, come on down here. I said, no, look at this view. It's beautiful. What do you want to do next? Let's do feels. Then we'll do.
Sure.
Is that a? Is this tune up? We're the first. Talk to me. We're the first of the first.
Yeah. So, Acceptance is the first band who's in our.
Napster Live Green Room Sessions. We're actually really happy to have you guys here. It's totally awesome, especially you guys are local. Just super sweet.
Yeah, so we like all that. It's a harmonious occasion.
Very much so.
We're pumped to be here.
Thanks for being here.
Yeah, for sure. All right, let's do.
I just happen to be in town as well.
No, that is another very important aspect of this.
Glad it worked out.
So, this song's called We Can't Escape, and I've played it acoustic maybe once or twice before. It's on Colliding by Design as well. So it's we've released a couple songs off this record that you can listen to Spotify, iTunes, all that stuff. This song's not actually one of those. Everywhere. Rhapsody, Napster, sorry, YouTube. Who else am I missing? Amazon. I don't know if I'm missing anybody. This one's not on there, but it's one that you could hear around here and there of us playing acoustic, so we'll go for it now. We'll cut all that out of the when we redo this and package it for the anthology.
Come in.
Yeah, they're like writing a list of things. Not okay. Don't let this artist talk. List check one. All right, ready.
Ready.
There comes a time when you can see it. There comes a time when love is fleeting. There comes a time when we all pretend. We all pretend the same. There comes a time when it won't matter. All the things that we're after leave us all alone together. All alone, be my heart, be my soul, be my all. Everything we've known, my head letting go of everything we've known. Be here with me, one voice, one beat. We can escape. This fate, living in a broken shelter, staring at an empty mirror. No one looking back. There's no one looking back. There'll come a time when it won't matter. All the things that we're after leave us here alone together. Here alone, be my heart, be my soul, be my all. Everything we've known, my head letting go of everything we've known. Be here with me, one voice and one beat. We can escape. This face, say what you are, what you are, what you are, and say what you are, what you are, what you are, say what you are, what you are, what you are, say what Sure. Mm-hmm. All right, so we'll do So Contagious.
Will we?
We should.
Okay.
This is a song off a record we put out in 05 called So Contagious. And I just saw an article that listed So Contagious in the top 50 of all-time love songs, in case you're wondering, see? And it had like a heart next
ever?
To it. Well, I mean, it was... The article was referencing Ever. I don't know that the scope of artists that were considered were in the Ever category, as you and I might know it. I can tell you that, for instance, Color Me Bad was not in there.
Oh, okay.
So I Wanna Sex You Up was not in the top 50. And so, or just consider this. We beat out I Wanna Sex You Up as one of the top 50 love songs of all time. Mm-hmm. And my wife's in the other room, and she's thinking, no, we probably didn't beat out Color Me Bad.
She's like, oh,
she's like, no, I Wanna Sex You Up is amazing. You guys all know what, you guys are from the Color Me Bad era, right? Okay. Phew. That would be pretty sick, right? We need to have a bigger repertoire. She's laughing right now because it's like on delay, so I'm just catching it. In the meantime, no big deal. Okay, so let's do So Contagious. Sorry, Color Me Bad.
Sorry about it.
Sorry.
Sorry about that.
Sorry. You are inspiration for the song, though.
Okay.
How's the song? Wait a second. I just keep thinking that song now. It's my head all of a sudden.
Just
okay, yeah, I got
lyrics
it.
To I Wanna Sex You Up.
Over
the music
of So Contagious.
Okay. Yeah. We'll see how that goes.
Like check that. Two. Make sure artist does not speak during live sessions, Napster live sessions. Okay, we got that. You guys are making notes, right? No alcohol either, just in case you guys are wondering. All right.
Bad combination.
Yeah, it's a bad combo. Okay. Couldn't be more unexpected, and I can tell that I've been moving in so slow. Don't let it throw you off too far, 'cause I'll be running right behind you. Could this be out of line? Could this be out of line? Say you're the only one breaking me down like this. You're the only one I would take a shot on. Keep me hanging on so contagiously. Oh, when I'm around you, I'm predictable. 'Cause I believe in loving you at first sight. I know it's crazy, but I'm hoping to take a hold of you. Could this this be out of line? Could this be out of line? Say you're the only one breaking me down like this. You're the only one I would take a shine on. Keep me hanging on so contagiously. Could this be out of line? Could this be out of line? Say you're the only one breaking me down like this. You're the only one I would take a shot on. Keep me hanging on so contagiously. Could this be out of line? To say you're the only one breaking me down like this. You're the only one I would take a shot on. So far, so good. Anything you want to throw in there? Somebody was asking, I saw somebody last night was saying, what's the feel like to have a record finished? I think it was a question I actually saw last night.
Yeah, we actually have a question from Adam. He asks, what is it like listening to a completed record for the first time?
So, it's pretty surreal for two reasons. One is, for those who may or may not know, we went basically, once this record comes out, it's in February, it will be just about 12 years between releases of records. So, you know, in 2005, when we were with Columbia Records and put our full length for Phantoms out, and then that's an interesting story that we don't have time for, but we went to make a second record. We were doing demos and writing and going through the process, and then ended up breaking up during that process. And I know for me, I know it's probably different for everybody, and we probably have different stories, because Christian went on to play in a band called Amber Lynn, and he was playing, you know, music out of, you know, for a long time.
The whole time, yeah.
The whole time. And I didn't even touch a guitar for the whole time. So we got back together. It was pretty surreal. We just got back together just to play some concerts, and then we had a lot of fun doing it, and we had written a song. And then this process has been now about over a year and a half of making this record.
It's 2 years, yeah.
And it's still, like, when we listen to it, the fact that we have a finished, like, I just think about, I got my, like, sons out there, I got a 4-year-old kid, and I'm like, you know, it'd be pretty cool to be able to have something that, you know, you create this piece of art, if you will, and it just, you can't take it away ever, you know. And I think I kind of realize how special that is. And when you're in the middle of it and you're young and we're playing music and we think, like, we own the world and nothing can stop us, like, you kind of almost take it for granted, right? Mm-hmm. Like, yeah, we'll do another record and we'll do a third one. And, I mean, you know, and I think that's probably the thing that, for me, for sure, doing this kind of just brought that back to where it's like, man, this is a privilege to be able to make music, to have a voice, to be able to share it with people. And we're going through, like, I mean, you add on everything that's happening in the world, in our world, and some, I mean, some pretty heavy stuff. And people are dealing with a lot of stuff that I think, A, they're having a hard time comprehending how to deal with it, navigate it. And it's surprising to me, you know, I keep thinking about, man, listen to music. Like back in the, like, when we were younger, and even before our generation, that was the place where a lot of people went when they were struggling to figure out how to identify with something that was happening. artists have would had music out there that you could listen to that would kind of guide you through these moments of history, even, you know. I mean, obviously we've got Woodstock, we've got Live Aid. I mean, there's some real moments of history that people gravitate to that were almost like culturally where young people or and anybody really could go, okay, this is going to help me figure out how to get through this, and we're going to rally and be able to have this message or what it follow this message. So now I'm like, when we think about the lyrical content and what we are trying to say in this record, it's pretty poignant to what's happening today. And I think it's a place that I hope people go to, you know, not only just listen to music and go, oh, Acceptance is back. Mm-hmm. Hope their music sounds awesome, and I can't wait to, you know, bump this in my car. But they'll also be like, hey, hopefully this is, you know, I remember Acceptance as a band that I could listen to in a lot of different places in my life, and hopefully this record does that as well. So I don't know. That's a long answer, but you know, I think it's an interesting time we're in for sure. So, hey, what about you, Christian? What do you think? Like, oh, it's just sweet.
Well, even just to speak on, you know, we even talked about it the other day when we were, shooting the video, but just to, when you listen back to where the song started from, and then to hear a complete finished version, and to kind of think like, wow, that this thing did not exist before. It's like a very validating, like very inspiring
the process,
and then also like what you're speaking to lyrically, you know, like the ability to have an impression on people and inspire other people and help people deal with life the same way that music helped you go through all the things in your life, you know. It's like it's a great responsibility, but it's a really cool opportunity as well, you know. So it's nice to get back together this many years later and actually realize the gravity of it all. Like you were saying, when you were younger, it's like, well, I don't know, I'm just writing songs, and like, you want to do it, but you don't realize like the impact that you really can have. So
hopefully the next question is, what's your favorite color? Blue, by the way.
Next question.
We'll do another song.
Yeah.
And we'll go from, we can hang out from there. Okay, so this is the last one that we'll do today that we know. And it's called Haunted. And we did, this is, you tell them, it's available to listen to, is that right? You know,
yeah,
probably better than I do.
Yeah, it's everywhere online. Just released we're calling it a lyric vid, but it's really more like a video that happens to have the lyrics in it. It's kind of like a hybrid, but that's on YouTube, and we'll be uploading it to our Facebook and everything. But yeah, it's a brand new song. It just came out last Friday, I believe, to the world.
Yeah. So that's
and the guys that wrote it just taught us how to play it.
Yeah. So
we're good to go.
Yeah. They're from Seattle, so that worked out. They're actually located on the floor under
somebody named Eddie Vader or something that, and Chris
Vader, whatever it is. Yeah. Anyhow, okay, this song's called Haunted.
We are haunted. I seem to have forgotten, clear and conscious. I seem to have forgotten, yeah, you know, it's more or less the same, but I'll take the blame. This town is getting so old, drive around for the weekend. I'll try to bear you my soul. Last call for the weekend. Yeah, you know, I've tried to fail. I've tried to fail. There's nothing I should fear in loving you, and I'm afraid this time that I'll be losing you. While I watch you go, while I watch you go. We are haunted. close to hear my name. You're disheartened. You'll change, you'll stay the same. You know I've tried my best to fail. I've tried to fail. There's nothing I should fear in loving you. And I'm afraid this time that I'll be losing you. While I watch you go. And while I watch you go. While the cold night air starts to blow, watch you go, watch you go, watch you go. While the cold night air starts to blow, watch you go, watch you go, watch you go. And I'm afraid this time that I'll be losing you. While I watch you go. While I watch you go. There's nothing I should fear in loving you. And I'm afraid this time that I'll be losing you. While I watch you go. While I watch you go. Watch you go, watch you go, watch you go. Watch you go, watch you go, watch you go. Watch you go, watch you go, watch you go. Watch you go, watch you go, watch you go.
Cool.
Yeah. Awesome. Thanks so much, guys. This has been totally amazing. Thanks for coming in for the first
absolutely
in the green room. We have just have a couple more questions online. Sure. So first question, tour. What are you guys doing? Planning? Are you guys thinking of one?
We've got next month, we've got three shows for our release of the record. We're playing in L.A., we're playing in San Francisco, we're playing here in Seattle on February 26th. We then go to Australia. We're going to go do Australia with Taking Back Sunday, and then we come back, and we'll be doing something between, that's in March, between March and late summer, we'll be doing stuff all around the country, and then hopefully come late summer, early fall, we'll be doing an acceptance tour as well. So we'll be in a city near you this year. That's the goal. I know a lot of people are like, when do we get to see acceptance come to our home? And I'd say this year is a very good bet for that, for just about anywhere. So
there's a lot of people from Mexico as well as the UK who have been asking.
Yeah, we're surprised. I mean, surprising. UK and in Australia, where we're going, this will be our first time into Australia as well, and so it's been pleasant, the amount of people that are like, we are so excited. Mm-hmm. People flying from New Zealand to you know, Sydney or different Melbourne or wherever. Mm-hmm. So
we didn't really leave the States.
Not very high, yeah.
Came to Canada.
Canada.
When we were touring 10 years.
That was sweet.
12 years ago. Yeah.
Sorry. Cool. So in Mexico. Yeah, I mean,
send us an offer.
No, yeah. If you cook for us, we will be there. Yeah, I mean, I could see we'll definitely, you know, UK, I mean, Europe, stuff like that, those things will all happen for sure. So hopefully get a chance to see you, whoever's asking. Mm-hmm. So
cool. The new single's out now. When can we expect the new album to be out?
Album's
seasonal.
It's February 24th is the album release date, and we've basically the two songs that have kind of made their way out into the world are really more kind of just teasers than anything. You know, as far as like a single, we haven't really, I don't know, and I don't even know if that's a thing anymore. But sure. You know, we wanted to get music out prior to the record. It's been a long time since people have been able to hear new music, and so the stuff that we're doing is, you know, it's interesting because we get people that are like, oh, this is an interesting single, or like, you know, this video. Oh, yeah. Yeah, this video, really what we wanted to do is we wanted to take a couple songs that we thought were you know, an interesting representation of the record, but also, you know, people that listened to Acceptance 10 years ago would be like, oh, cool, I'm getting excited for this record. And then we wanted to have some level of visual that accompanied that those songs. And so we did that lyric video, and then we did kind of a conceptual lyric video. And mm-hmm. But we do have, you know, when the record comes out, we'll have a song that I think releases with the record that may be more of like a, what you would call like whatever. I don't know. It doesn't matter. We love all the songs, so it's going to be fine.
Yeah. All number one hits.
Yeah. So.
Well, everyone's really excited based off of the comments that we've been seeing online. People are really excited you guys are back together touring and whatnot. We've seen lots of people comment of bringing back memories of the times that they listened to Phantoms and a bunch of other songs. So congrats to you guys being together. Thanks for coming by after live.
Yeah, thanks for having us, for sure.
Thanks and to then everybody that watched.
Yeah.
We'll have this available here in the future, and best of luck on the next travels.
Thanks, guys. Yeah. Appreciate it. Cool.
Thank you.
Thanks. All right.
Thanks for tuning in after live. Tune into our Twitter, Facebook accounts for updates on Acceptance. Thanks a lot.